This tutorial will show how to use SAP 2000 to model staged construction of a cable stayed bridge using the Construction Scheduler feature. It will have two spans, each 100 meters in length, with a single steel pylon 60 meters tall. The deck will be a concrete box section, 6 meters wide, and will be constructed in 10 stages. We start the process by clicking on File, New Model, and selecting the units as kilonewton meters. We will construct the model using only grids, so click on the Grid Only button. We will have a total of 3 grid lines in each direction. Click on the Define Coordinate Systems Grids command, and then the Modify Show button to bring up the Define Grid System data form. For the X direction, which is along the span, our coordinates will be minus 100, 0, and positive 100. In the Y direction, which is across the deck width, we will enter minus 3, 3, and 0. In the Z direction, which is vertical, we enter minus 10, 0, and 50. We will work in only one window, so close the plan window and then go to the Define Section Properties Frame Sections command. Here we will add pipe sections to define a non-prismatic pylon. Make sure that the frame section property type is set to steel and click the pipe button. We start with the bottom section and enter 1.2 meters for the diameter and 0.05 for the thickness. We will add another pipe section to model the pylon at the top. Here it has a diameter of 0.6 meters and then again a thickness of 0.05. Next, we take the previously defined sections and create a non-prismatic section. Select Other from the frame section property type and click the non-prismatic button. We will call it pylon and use the top section as the start section and the bottom section as the end. It will be varied over the entire length in a cubic variation. Next, we zoom in on the pylon location and draw the pylon object. Starting at the top and going to the bottom to match our member definition. We leave the draw mode and shut off the grids under the View menu. Next, we will draw joints to model the saddle locations for the cables. The first joint will be 4 meters below the top of the pylon. By clicking on the top of the pylon with the offset set to minus 4 meters, a joint is added. We leave the Draw menu, select the joint just drawn, and go to the Edit Replicate command. Here, we will add additional joints for the saddles at 2-meter intervals below the selected joint. This gives us a total of 9 cable to pylon connections. Next, we will modify the concrete material property to include time-dependent properties. Make sure that 4000 PSI is selected, which is our concrete material, and click the Modify Show button. Check the Switch to Advanced Property display box, and then the Modify Show Material Properties button. Lastly, click the Time Dependent Properties button. In this model, we will include both creep and shrinkage effects. We will set the shrinkage start age to be 3 days, and we'll use the full integration creep analysis type. Next, we will define the concrete box girder to be used for the deck. Select the material to be concrete and click on the tube button. Input a depth of 1.2 meters. A width of 6 meters, a flange thickness of 0.2, and a web thickness of 0.3. Toggle the grids back on and switch to an XY plan view. And toggle down to the Z equals 0 level.